once upon a future time in a place called Stardust Bay. Counting down to adventure now. Rockets on a mission, we're on our way. Space racers, surfing the solar winds. Space racers, together the fun begins. Way out where the planets, moons, and stars all shimmer, shine, shine. Having a great time exploring space racers.
Hey, wait for me! Raven, is that you?
And yours truly.
And me. Hi, Robin.
Care to join us for a little late-night Orbo game with my new glow-in-the-dark orb?
Let me think. No, we all have a very early mission with Sandpiper tomorrow. Remember?
Ah, you're such a goody-goody teacher's pet. Come on, let's bounce.
Ugh. Look at it glow. Why didn't somebody think of this years ago?
Scar!
Shh!
Oops. Scar!
All right!
Eagle! Shh! Remember? This is a very bad idea. We should run and hide.
We're transferred to another school. We're not going anywhere. Not without my new orb. We just have to be really quiet.
Ah! We woke up Headmaster Crane! Go, 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 go!
I must have been dreaming. As a wise rocket once said...
And that's when we saw a ghost! The ghost of a miniature tree!
Or an optical illusion caused by the moonlight reflecting off the glowing orb and, Hawk's sweat.
Neither of those make sense.
How else do you explain a little tree in a pod floating in Headmaster Crane's garden?
Oh, that's his new bonsai. Bonsais are miniature trees. And this one is special because it...
Good morning, cadets. All set for our mission? Wait. Where's Raven?
Here I am, Sandpiper. Sorry, overslept. Some crazy kids kept me awake all night.
Hey, Robin. So how did Headmaster Crane's bonsai float like that?
Who cares? Plants are weird.
There's a magnet at the bottom of the pot and one on the pot holder below. They create a magnetic force that push each other away.
Huh?
Ava, can you show us, please?
With pleasure. All magnets have opposing ends called the North and South Pole. Opposite poles attract, which means they stick together. While same poles repel, which means they push each other away.
It was repelling magnets that kept the tree floating above the base.
Okay, that's the how, but why? What's the point?
Well, Headmaster Crane says they're the latest thing in Zen garden design.
A fine explanation, Robin. You can tell me later what you were doing in Headmaster Crane's garden last night.
Nice going, teacher's pet.
Whoa! Looks like something really big hit this satellite.
Something did. Your mission is to repair this and another nearby satellite. Are we keeping you up, Eagle?
Sorry, Sandpiper. I didn't get enough sleep last night. I really need a solid 8 hours to maintain these good looks.
Let's divide you into two teams. Okay, Raven, you'll be paired with Robin.
What?
Eagle, that means we're partners!
Sandpiper, may I request a new teammate for, scientific reasons? Raven and I can't work together. We're complete opposites.
Yeah, this is lame.
See? I'm polite, he's rude. I'm early, he's late. I'm...
Robin, Sometimes opposites join together, just like magnets. You two will work on this satellite as a team. Eagle, Hawk, follow me to yours. I'll check back with you all in a couple of hours.
A couple of hours?
We have a lot of work to do, so... Raven? Now where are you?
Boo! You should have seen your face.
Oh, brother.
Antenna?
Broken! Transceiver?
Intact! Teamwork?
Excellent!
Thrusters operational. Fuel tank looks okay.
All right!
How about we high-five in our minds, just to keep things moving? What was that? I was high-fiving you in my mind.
I know. I was pretending to catch it. Are we a great team or what? Gee, I hope Robyn and Raven are having this much fun.
Oh, they're fine.
Eagle, Raven's driving me crazy. He sliced a loose cable with his wing and now it's dangling. The cable, not the wing.
Hawk, it's me, Raven. Robyn is seriously cramping my style. She insists we work together.
That's called teamwork.
What?
Yeah, have you tried teamwork?
What?
Teamwork!
Fine, I'll try. Over and out.
That was terrible. They'll never repair that satellite in time.
We need to go over there.
But we still have work to do.
We can still work on our satellite. Come on, help me move this thing.
But won't showing off our superior teamwork make Robyn and Raven feel worse?
No worries, my friend. We'll stay out of sight and watch them without them knowing.
Oh, like the time Captain Cosmo spied on the giant space ants?
Yeah, exactly. If Robyn and Raven need our help, we'll be right there.
Brilliant!
And that's why we're a great team, Hawky. You always agree with me.
The big thingamabobs are working.
Main transponders, check.
Right what's-its is busted.
Right thruster dismantled, check. Can we please use the proper scientific terms?
Why? I know you know what I mean.
Oh, I'm glad you're up there and I'm down here, because if you were working next to me, I'd probably...
Bubble blip. Frazzle flip. That's right. I have my own secret space language. Want to hear more?
No, thank you. While you fly around making up nonsense words, I'm going to do some actual work.
Hey, I work. I was just about to straighten that solar panel. Oops, sorry.
From now on, you stay here, I'll stay over there, and we work alone.
Fly solo, any day-o, no problemo.
And no more talking! If either one of us forgets the rules, we just have to say two code words, like, solar situation.
Really? That's your secret space language?
You're talking again! Solar situation!
It's worse than I thought.
Yeah, these cables are a mess.
No, Robyn and Raven. They're not even trying to get along now.
In that case, let's stitch these cables and get comfortable. We're gonna be here a while.
But we still have work to do. Ow! Now might be a good time to go over Captain Cosmos' spying rules. First, you are there to observe. Stay alert at all times. Eagle!
Huh? What'd I miss? Sorry. We got this! High five!
I'm high-fiving you in my mind. And so it goes, with Robyn and Raven working really well together, but still not speaking. While Eagle abandons all spying rules and drools in his sleep.
Ow! Why does that keep happening? This place is so small.
We really should get back to work on our satellite. Sandpiper will be here soon and we're still not done.
No worries, amigo. We've got this. There's still plenty of time to get it finished.
But we have work to do! Eagle! Well, maybe it's this too tight space or the 8 rocket fuel boxes I drank while you were sleeping, but I'm starting to think that maybe we're opposites.
That's silly. How can we be best friends if that's true?
Well, that's how it feels.
Fine. Let's fix the cables.
Nope!
Hawk, a little help?
Hold still, you're making it worse!
What's taking so long?
Now I'm stuck too!
What? How'd that happen?
I was helping you.
You sure messed that up!
Finally, we agree on something!
Satellite inspected and repaired.
Were you talking to me?
No. Solar situation, remember?
Right. I'm finished too.
Great! I mean, huh? What's that?
Robyn!
Can you help us get free?
I'll try, but I'm not as good at this as Raven is.
Call him! Please!
I can't. We promised not to talk to each other. I doubt he'd even come over. Wait, I know. Raven, we have an un-solar situation. Do you read me? The opposite of solar situation.
Huh? Huh.
Bubble blip. You rang?
Good work. See? Opposites can stick together, like magnets. While Eagle and Hawk clean up their mess, why don't you two take a little break?
Thanks, Sandpiper.
Teacher's pet.
Solar situation. Not.
Hey, Eagle, how come we don't have a secret language?
Later, Hawkey. Later.